Sarawak Welcome Berhad, or SOPB, are a Malaysian public company listed on Bursa Malaysia. SOPB Upstream, Oil Palm Estate and Miles are all located in the state of Sarawak, which is the largest state in Malaysia, and Malaysia is one of the largest world oil palm growing region. Sarawak Welcome Berhad achieved a highest in profit after tax in 2017 that leaped to 4.91 million. For the agriculture GDP growth, the highest GDP was recorded for fourth quarter in 2019 with the amount of 208,030 million, and the oil palm stand the highest GDP contribution in 2018 with the amount of 37.9%.
My name is Tung Jia Hui. Now I will present about credit risk analysis. Sarawak Oil Palms Berhad had a good financial health in debt ratio, debt to equity ratio and payable period. This shows the creditor have lower risk of not retaining the principal and interest payment of debt. However, the company has a sales rate and cost its sales growth rate and profit growth rate drop in these 2 years. The company need to consider this risk and implement some steps to increase their sales and profit in order to get a better financial performance. Thank you.
I'm Cho Meni. I'm going to explain about the part of liquidity analysis. And liquidity ratio analysis actually is the we use several ratio to actually determine the ability of an organization to pay off its debt. Yeah. So from the result itself, the Sarawak Palm Oil Berhad, their current ratio in 2019 is actually 6.66, and also their asset test ratio is 6.23. This actually indicate that they actually have more liquidity to actually pay off their debt, which is a good sign for a company. Yeah. So the next thing actually is receivable turnover in days. In this ratio, actually is the higher ratio, which means that there is more frequent to have cash collection occurs. And for that itself, comparing to 2018, it's actually dropped 0.02, which from 2.87 to 2.85. Yeah, that's all for me. Thank you.
I will be explaining about market risk analysis. For the GDP analysis, we have analyzed that Indonesia has the strongest correlation of the GDP with the oil palm consumption, but Philippines has the lowest. And then for the GDP per capita analysis, all three countries have significant relationship between the oil palm consumption and the GDP per capita. And then for the inflation rate analysis, we have found that Indonesia has totally no relationship between the inflation rate and the oil palm consumption. And then last but not least, at the interest rate analysis, the changes of interest rate will not affect the oil palm consumption of the Indonesia and also Philippines. Thank you.
So as the number of demand on the palm oil products, the identification of the risk expansion in this area is crucial for the companies to be prepared in having the business objectives smoothly being executed. The risk assessment of the Sarawak Oil Palms Berhad is wide and covering various aspects of the business. So the Sarawak Palm Oil Berhad is holding the risk from various aspects, such as business risk on the profit and loss, for instance, the country risk, such as the environmental problems, the currency or foreign exchange, such as financial transaction that take place using a currency that's different to the base currency of the company or individual, and fluctuations of foreign exchange and politics of Malaysia risk involving taxes.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Muhammad Zufaiz. I'm going to talk about human resource for Sarawak Oil Palm. There are four. The first one is human being, whereby they focus on providing the employee with the environment that will enhance their production. And then the second one is family and business relationship, where 20% of the CEO, 20% of the manager is from the CEO's family. Then the third one is employee management. They create a code of conduct for all employees to follow. Then the last one is transition plan. Transition plan is where they want to sustain the business.